samey.
Yep.
And whereas you can see advantages to that, then can you see... Oh, this is your profile.
That's nice. This jab.
Can you see... Can you change that? Can you make it more...
This is something I've built this profile. We're a business and enterprise manager. We wanted something a little bit business-like for our staff portal.
Okay.
The student portal is similar, but lots more pictures.
And I can log into the parent portal and show you that as well.
Okay, go. And is this like a, you have a, how do you find the whole Facebook thing that they do with friends and profiles and stuff?
Yeah, fine. We can monitor it completely. It's obviously it's a safe network because it's a school one. They can't contact anyone out of the school.
Yeah.
So it's much safer and a good way to learn how to use those kind of sites and keep yourself safe. So this is Carol. Carol's a lady I share an office with at work actually, but she's got two children in the school, Bobby and Katie.
Okay.
She logs in as a parent. Again, because from Action Sims, it lists all the subjects that Bobby does.
With their teachers?
With their teachers.
Click on a teacher for me?
Can't click on those.
They're not linked.
Okay.
We can do that, but we've disabled that.
You can do that, so you can go to teacher profile.
Yeah.
Okay, here's Bobby and Katie is her other daughter.
Yep, and then you can click on the attendance link over here.
So we'll just run down that before you click on it. We've got that. We've got attendance, parent voice, school calendar, governor's report, update details, school contact and parent portal. Here is the attendance data.
This is, we do lesson by lesson attendance as well as AM.
Okay. So that mimics Sims reports, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Very good. Scroll down, please. That's just codes. Okay. Very good. And that's, yeah, that's for the week. If you want to look at a more wider scope for data, attendance data, like over the year or a term?
Yeah, we can do that. We haven't got that at the moment, but you can narrow it down to individual lessons. You can identify the child is skipping maths every week.
Brilliant. Parents portal, these are forums for parents.
This is a parent forum, but it's a little bit fancy in that you've got this vote button here, so parents can suggest, I think the school should do whatever, and if it's a good idea, they can get voted up, and then the
parents can vote for it.
Real action.
Okay. And, but then, doesn't that, the school might be a little bit worried that parents are going to say, well, we'll do this, and then 100 parents vote for it, more than 100 for anything else, and it's like the kids wear jeans to school.
Yep, it's possible.
Yeah, okay. Right.
But what we do is we set that up so anytime a parent posts it to there, it does email one of us so we can monitor it to make sure it is appropriate for the other parents to see it.
And what you're going to do about your little formatting error here, round the corners against the square corner, it's inconsistent there, Jeff.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah.
Okay. okay, pop me into a pupil, please.
Daisy, one of our Year 7 students. There she is.
Fab, so that comes on today. It looks like that. These are all her different classes, but not imminent work. That's people writing a wall, so that's like a Facebook status thing. Down the bottom, these links come for everybody, and they're just whatever you want them to be, basically. Okay, scroll up, please. So let's go to my marks. Brain training, I'm assuming, is just like a DS thing.
Similar, yeah. We had students playing games and brain time lunch, and we wanted them to be a bit more useful, so we put some brain training in maths.
Okay, my time table, please. Rule, can I change the view to a week or something?
No, you can't, no.
Right, okay, so that's just for the day. Again, that's like the Sims front page.
There is another one. You can go to personal and planner. No, that link's not working, but that gives you the week view, so you can see everything that's going on.
Okay, because that's like your planner and stuff like that.
Yeah.
What about kids entering data on this? So they can write on each other's walls, can they update their calendars?
Yeah, they've got their own personal calendar, which they can link to on their remote, but they can go to the planner, they've got their own personal page.
Okay, what about student forums, student council?
That kind of thing, yeah.
They have forums buttons at the end. Okay, let's crack through this. So you've got the dashboard that we've been looking at. Personal, that's shop and move out for these things. You get a choice there of ePortfolio, My Marks, Planner, Secure Gateway, Set Work. The ePortfolio just puts documents up in the cloud, or takes documents that are in the cloud already and makes them into the ePortfolio. Does it display them?
Yeah.
Like web pages?
Yeah, and
they download them.
They can create their own web pages.
They can create their own web pages.
Okay, so they can create
their own. Fabulous. Go on to Set Work.
Oh dear. I promise you, we're both logging in and out so many times today, so...
Okay, no worries, let's try and get back. The school drives, let's try that one. These are what?
This is a direct link from a network service back in school. Yep. So Daisy can access all of her documents from wherever she is.
Her documents, what about shared documents?
There's also a link over here. Again, this is just a replication. This is a live link to our servers.
So inside ICT, for example, there will be a year 7 folder, and that's what Daisy can see. Can you see year 8, year 9, year 10?
You can just change it to however you want to do. We let all of our students see it.
Very good, thank you. Now, can we have a look at subjects, please? Okay, so these three departments are in the lead?
Yes.
As far as frog development goes?
Every department's got their own folder and put their resources in.
Yep.
Once they create their own web page, their own department site, they get promoted, they get a badge at the top, and they go straight to their own website.
Languages, please.
This is our language site. That's
right. How is that created? Just a website?
All within Frog.
Is it within Frog? So this is there's something that helps the teacher then to do this?
Yeah, I'll log back in as me in a minute, and there's a little edit button we can go to there. That's great, that.
Okay, can you do that, please? You had a look at OpenHive, by the way?
No.
No, it's a new one on the market.
So we've got edit page up in the top corner here.
Lovely.
Look at that. Straight away puts it into editing mode so you can see the dotted line around here.
Okay, can I embed YouTube in this?
Yes.
Can I embed anything in this, like mind maps that are done online and things like that?
Yes, you can. Yep, there's an HTML component. All you do with these, find the one you want, click on it, drag it into the page.
Yep.
Double click and then you can edit it away.
So you drag it, so you put a box in it and it's basically doing table structure.
Yeah.
All works in tables.
All drag and drop.
Fab, okay. And then you can choose from 2 columns, 3 columns, heading, blank space, text and pictures, 4 columns, 5 columns, boxes and margins, that's like a PowerPoint thing.
You can indent the page a little bit, put a box around some text.
Send me please, can I just have a quick look at that because that looks quite important. It's basically HTML. I want another way of doing HTML. The sorts of things that you do if you're I would do my Google HTML editor, but more widgety, I guess.
You've got all these different categories as well.
Okay, cool. Let's have a look at this.
More bricks to drag in.
Different bricks. Accordion menu. Like accordion menus, they're a very good thing. But cool down combo, that's fine too. Okay, next one. Media. Rollover image, video, RSS reader, Flash, text and pictures, meta tag media, meta tag search, Java, RAW, MP3, okay? Oh, and there's more, meta tag, okay, that's cool. Vote results, we like that, votes are good. Collaboration, discussion, chat, diary, timetable, email, list, workspaces. What's list workspaces?
That's a new feature, we haven't started using that, so I can't help you on that one.
Okay, very good.
These are the admin tools.
Right, so how do you find this works? Obviously, we get, it's a different thing. So we can see the blue sky thing, the kind of vision, as it were, of having everybody putting stuff online for every course with every class. But before we get to that, how do you find Frog works for that kind of interim? So just having a little bit, like you've got your 3 languages plan start on,
Have
a little bit like that, and then more people coming in. The progression, as it were, the rollout.
Yeah, so the 3 that have already started, other departments are looking at it now, and they're motivated to start into the department
I'm not looking at you, honestly.
To build better web pages, so modify language and put theirs up, and then IT will do one better. So it's a nice competition between the staff to keep developing and pushing on.
Fabulous. Okay, that's it. Brilliant. Thank you very much.
Thank you.